Hello students, in the previous section we discussed about the what is the specific role of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium and what are the deficiency symptoms and toxicity symptoms of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. So in this section we discuss about the what is the functions and deficiency symptoms of calcium and other remaining macro and micronutrients. So these calcium, they are absorbed by the form in the form of calcium ion. And what are the important main functions of this calcium? It stimulates the ammonium absorption in the form of calcium pectate. It is responsible for holding together the cell walls of plants. Means it plays a very important role in synthesis of cell wall and important in guard cell physiology, especially in stomata closure. So we know that the process of transpiration is dependent upon the turgidity of guard cell. So this guard cell become open and close is on the basis of whether the guard cell is turgid and or flaccid. So this calcium is play a very important role to maintain this closure and opening of stomata. So that's why it's play a very important role in the opening and closing of stomata. Then it is used to activating certain enzymes and send to the signals that coordinate certain cellular activity. So we know that there are several enzymes, they are necessary for the various metabolic activities of the plant. So this calcium is play a very important role to activate the enzymes which are necessary for the various metabolic process, which includes the photosynthesis, respiration, transpiration, electron transport chain. So these are activities which depend upon the enzymes, and these enzymes is activated by this calcium. Then what are the deficiency symptoms produced by the calcium? So young leaves and fruits display calcium deficiency first. So why this? Because they are appears on the young leaves, because calcium is an immobile element, so it cannot be moved from one place to the another place. So whatever the deficiency symptoms, they appears firstly on the young leaves, and young leaves and fruits display the calcium deficiency firstly. Then blossom end rot of tomatoes is a classic case of calcium deficiency. Means blossom end root of tomatoes, this is the main symptoms of this calcium in case of the tomato. Then yellow brown spots surrounded by sharp brown outline edge, so this is the second deficiency symptoms of calcium. Then toxicity, see if this calcium concentration is more than the requirement, then it's causes the several effects, but rarely this calcium toxicity there occurs in a plant. But if this occurs, the high level of calcium can compete with the magnesium and potassium uptake, causing their deficiency. If this calcium level is high, then it affects the absorption or uptake of magnesium and potassium. Means this having a antagonistic effect of magnesium and potassium if this calcium is more. Then this is the deficiency. We found that this is the border of this leaves, they become dark brown in color because of the this deficiency of calcium, because it particularly inhibits the cell wall formation. So that's why this browning of this margin of these leaves we are found on the leaf region, and particularly they are found on the younger parts of the plant or young leaves. This is this tomato end rot disease of this because of this due to the deficiency of the calcium. Then next important macro element, that is the magnesium. So this magnesium, they are absorbed by the plant in the form of magnesium ion, likewise the calcium ion, and it's become mobile element, means this mobility is very high, they are moves from one place to the another place in the plant. The important functions is chlorophyll formation. So magnesium is a central molecule of this chlorophyll in the molecular formula of the chlorophyll, so that's why it is important for the chlorophyll formation. Then synthesis of amino acids and cell protein. Then resistance to unfavorable factors. Then vitamin A and C concentrations. So whatever the resistance to the unfavorable factors means particularly when there is unfavorable conditions in a plant. So because of the magnesium presence, it resists these unfavorable factors because of presence of magnesium. And vitamin A and C concentration is depend upon how much magnesium in the plant. So it affects the A and C vitamin concentration and it resists the unfavorable factors of the environment. Then what are the deficiency symptoms of the magnesium? So this deficiency are not common in many of the plant, but because of this if this magnesium is deficient in some of the plant, they shows the yellowing between leaf veins, sometimes with reddish brown tints on the leaf surface, and early leaf fall because of this deficiency of magnesium. And toxicity related to the toxicity, so maximum toxicity are very rare because deficiency somewhat they are rare, so that's why the toxicity is also somewhat rare and not even exhibited by any plant this toxicity of magnesium. So this is the deficiency, low magnesium content and adequate magnesium content. We found there is a yellow region in the intervenal parts of the plant, that is leaf vein. So this is because of the lower chlorophyll synthesis, and which leads to this type of the symptoms. The next important elements is the sulfur. So sulfur is essential for the growth and development of all the crop, and as we know that the sulfur is one of the important macro elements which are required in very large quantity, but they are categorized as a secondary elements or secondary macro elements. They are absorbed through the roots in the form of sulfate, and this is sulfate is immobile nutrient. So likewise this calcium, this sulfur is also another immobile elements. So whatever the that deficient symptoms, they are found on the younger parts of the plant. Then what are the important functions? So formation of chlorophyll is the another important function of the sulfur. Like magnesium, sulfur is also involved in the synthesis of chlorophyll. Then production of proteins, sulfur containing proteins or sulfur containing amino acids. Then synthesis of oil in oil seed crop. Majority of the oil seed crops, they are required to synthesize the oils. So for that purpose, sulfurs play a very important role to convert these components into the oil. So sulfur is involved in this activity. Then activation of many enzymes which are necessary for the various metabolic processes. Then what are the deficiency symptoms? So yellowing of the entire leaf including the veins, usually starting with the younger leaves. Because of this immobile nature, so this sulfur is not unable to move from one place to the another. So this whatever the symptom there firstly appears on the younger leaves. Then leaf tips may yellow and curl downward side. Then toxicity, so leaf size will be reduced because of this sulfur toxicity. Then overall growth will be stunted if this sulfur is provided more than the requirement, and leaves yellowing or scorched at the edge. Means leaves becomes yellowing or sometimes they are scorched at the edges region. So these are the symptoms of the sulfur deficiency. We found that this is the region where the sulfur is somehow they can be deficiency produce the synthesis of chlorophyll, somehow they are affected, and due to which the leaves become appears as a yellowing leaves, and the yellowing of leaves is start from the that is the young leaves or from the margins toward the veins, and overall leaves become the yellow in appearance. So this is because of the sulfur deficiency. In some of this is the symptoms of sulfur deficiency in the that is corn, that is we found that is yellowish leaves. We are finding that there is a vein becomes there yellow because of this sulfur deficiency. And this is the some of the deficient symptoms which are found in a tomato because of the sulfur. The next is the that is the sulfur deficiency and the normal plant. So we found that is stunted growth, we found that, and that is there is deficiency of sulfur, and this is the normal growth, and this is the particularly in the flowering plants. So we found that this because of sulfur density, there is a appearance, it is yellowish appearance in the appearance in the leaves of the plant because of this deficiency of sulfur. Then next is the boron. So boron is also one of the macro elements. The boron uptake by plant is controlled by the boron level in soil solution rather than the total boron content in the soil. So boron uptake is a passive process and it moves with the water in plant tissue and accumulate in the leaves. So whatever the water, whatever these nutrients which are present in the soil, the some of the nutrient they are mixed with the water as a soil solution. So likewise boron is also they are mixed with the soil solution and that's why they are uptake by the plant with the water and they are accumulated in the leaves. So by the passive process of water absorption, these boron absorbed by the plant through a passive absorption of water. Then what are the deficiency symptoms of this boron? So there is a limited budding because of the deficiency of boron. Then bud break because of this water concentration imbalance. Then distorted shoot growth and short internodes increased branching. The size of the internode is short, but the branching is increased because of the deficiency of boron. And toxicity symptoms produce the symptoms. They likewise the chlorotic leaf tips. The leaf tips become chlorotic. Then leaf necrosis occurs because of this toxicity. Leaf falling. Sometimes if this boron is more than the requirement, there is a leaf fall, and even plant will should lead to death because of the heavy dose of the boron. So these are the deficiency symptoms of boron. So we see that is the chlorotic. That is the symptoms on the leaf margin region, and this is the some of the necrotic spots which are found on the leaf region because of the deficiency of boron. Then chlorine. So chlorine is important, or they are needed in small quantities as micro elements and aids in plant metabolism, that is photosynthesis, osmosis and ionic balance within the cell. So chlorine is very important for the photosynthesis process, that is in the light reaction of photosynthesis. So they are required in very less quantity, but their presence is very important. If this chlorine is deficient, then definitely this photosynthesis and osmosis process is inhibited. So important function, that is they participate in several physiological and metabolic processes which include plant growth and development, then osmotic and stomata regulation, osmosis regulation and stomata regulation, then evolution of oxygen in photosynthesis. As we know that in the Hill's reaction or in the light reaction, oxygen is evolved by the process of photolysis of water, and this photolysis of water is because of presence of chlorine. Second important, that is disease and resistance and tolerance. If this chlorine is present in the plant, which resist and tolerate the various diseases, that important in the opening and closing of stomata. Then chloride function in cation balance and transport within the plant. So why chlorine is important? In order to balance the cations in both the side, means outside the membrane and inside the membrane. So this ionic balance or cation balance is because of the presence of chlorine. Then what are the deficiency symptoms of chlorine? Chlorine deficiency can occur if there is a consistently less than 2 ppm chloride in the growing medium. Then chlorotic blotches with the necrotic spots located between the veins or on the margin of the younger leaves. So chlorine is an immobile element. So deficiency symptoms there appears on the young leaves. Then in advanced cases, chlorine deficiency could cause plant wilting because of this deficiency of chloron. And if this chloron is in excess amount, that is we call as a toxicity. So chloride toxicity starts as premature yellowing in leaves, then in marginal or tip necrosis of older leaves. Sometimes these toxicity symptoms, they are found in the premature yellowing of the leaves, and then it is marginal yellowing of the leaves, or sometimes there is a necrosis, tip necrosis of older leaves, there occurs because of this toxicity of chlorine. So this we found that is the deficiency of chlorine, and because of that there is a necrosis and chlorosis there occurs in the leaf because of this deficiency of chlorine. Then copper. So copper is essential to the plant growth and among the other things it plays a part in several enzymes production and it's a key to the formation of chlorophyll. So magnesium, sulfur, likewise the copper is also involved in the synthesis or formation of chlorophyll and many other enzymes is also that is the part of this enzyme or it acts as a coenzyme in some of the plant species. So this is very important role in the enzymatic activity. And secondly, they are in the formation of chlorophyll. So normal range of in growing medium is 0.05 to 0.5 ppm. If this copper is present, then there is a normal growth of the plant there occurs. But this, if this ranges is decreased, then definitely the deficiency is copper there occurs. This although the copper deficiency or toxicities they are very rarely occurs in nature and it is best to avoid either extreme as both can have negative impact on the crop. If these deficiencies there then definitely is a negative impact on the crop and if toxicity is there is also a negative impact on the crop growth. So it is very rarely occur and but in order to avoid this situation so we can provide this copper in between the 0.05 to 0.5 ppm range. Then functions, so activate some enzymes in plants which are involved in lignin synthesis and it is essential in several enzyme systems. Then require in the process of photosynthesis, respiration and assist in plant metabolism of carbohydrates and proteins and serves flavor and color in vegetables and flowers. So there are main role of this copper in which serves the flavor and color in vegetables and flowers plant. Then deficiency, so deficiency symptoms occurs in newer plants means this is because of these immobile in nature, that's why they are appears on the newer plants parts. The symptom starts as chlorosis of either whole leaf or in between the veins of newer leaves and with the chlorotic areas of the leaf small necrotic spots may they are formed on the leaf, especially on the leaf margin region. Leaves become small in size and become they are wilted and apical meristems may become necrotic and die because of this copper deficiency and inhibit the growth of lateral branches because of the deficiency of copper. Then toxicity, so excessive copper can restrict root growth by burning the root tips because of excess concentration of copper. Then compete with plant uptake of iron and sometimes molybdenum and zinc. If this copper concentration is more, then it compete with the iron and sometimes molybdenum and zinc. Then reduce branching and eventually the plant becomes die because of this toxicity of copper. So this is the toxicity symptoms which are appears on the leaves and particularly we see that the chlorosis and necrosis spot on the leaves and they become found on the young plants and the spots they are also found on the leaf margin region, that is yellow spot were found, that this is the because of the chlorophyll synthesis somehow they can be affected. So this is the spots because of this deficiency of the copper.